collect. Oh, wale. Oh, one net. Makam, body to correct. Oh, no, no, no. Erima, no forget. Money ko pefu. Oh, collect. Oh, wale. Oh, one net. Makam, body to correct. Say she love me. They all love it. Sensima. Why they for her? Benzema. Why you want a dollar? Sensima. This kind dance, you the dance. I'm doing the singing, you doing the dancing. Benzema. Why they for her? Benzema. Why you want a dollar? Sensima. This kind dance, you the dance. I'm doing the singing, you doing the dancing.
Benzema. Baby, chama nama like I do. So down, down, go back when all I want me can do. I need go to buy, think you have to buy the food that you go. Body,
to welcome you to this reception for the writers on the shortlist of the Nigeria Prize for Literature, sponsored by the Nigeria Liquefied Natural Gas Limited, based here in Port Harcourt. Now, when we think of Port Harcourt, the image that comes to us is oil and gas, and rightly so. Or we may remember the beautiful landscape that earned us the name of Nigeria's Garden City. But beyond that, Port Harcourt has a rich literary heritage. It is the home of writers like novelist Tedechi Amadi, poet Gabriel Okara, and Ken Saro-Wiwa. In recent years, writers like Haine Agari, who incidentally once won the Nigeria Prize for Literature, and others like Igoni Barrett, Chimeka Garrett, and Jowo Ile have emerged from this city. It is here that the playwright Olarotimi worked, developing creative talent at the CRAB, which is the theater of the University of Port Harcourt, producing gifted Nollywood actors like Hilda Dokubo, Sam Dede, and Rita Dominic. This is where the work of Nigeria LNG in endowing this literary award is so important. LNG stands out amongst its peers. With the inauguration of the Nigeria Prize for Literature in 2004, Nigeria LNG has demonstrated its commitment to literary craftsmanship. Today, this prize is the biggest in Africa. I think LNG deserves an applause. Yeah. So we thank LNG for moving a step further, particularly thank the general manager, Mr. Andy Ode, for bringing this reception of the shortlist for Harcourt. It's a great encouragement to the literary community and the creatives by extension.
So, Port Harcourt has always been a home of creativity, whether you like it or not. As she said, Grammy Award winner Bonaboy. Read to children right here in Port Harcourt. Who knows, you may be reading to some future Grammy Award winners. So, we'll have some display of creativity here today. And before we go to that, I just want to say we'll have a quiz right here. Prizes to be won. The beauty of this production is enhanced by the use of sonorous ijaw flute called the Oja. I hope I got that right. The native drum which flavors the piece with the sounds of the river and the mellifluous choruses that are a sound of hope of the Niger Delta. This will glue the audience to their seats, so you will be glued to your seat as you eat. Written by Dan Godo, presented by Ume, Chidema, Stephanie, ladies and gentlemen, Blacko, a round of applause for them, please.
Induced catastrophic happenings, a problem of the people, or should the gods of the land be blamed? Democracy, government by the people, of the people, and for the people. A tale it is of a kingdom so large, yet deluge of the vein of your fathers. Not even crumbs are left for the masses. And so the boys, sons of our land, sons from our womb, womb of the crab, crab of the sea, seeds of the Niger Delta region, our sons decided to take laws into their own hands.
The jaw flute. First time I'm doing that, the jaws, and I'm from. I don't want to embarrass myself. I just felt, you know, when it comes to the jaw nation, all we have is dances and drums. But flute, I just felt the flute was for other ethnic regions. I'm being educated there. So it was wonderful, wonderful. Get ready, get ready, get ready. Since the inception of the Nigeria Prize for Literature, how many times have the judges and advisory board not announced the winner? This one is feeling like Funamas, the white, the eggs, over, you know. 3, 2, 1. Wow. A galaxy is climbing up the table. The wolf has totally given up on this competition. I can't find the wolf anymore. Abelaji. I'm sorry, I must have upset you by calling your name because you are vexed to the top. You know, an Orubebe issue soon or later. It looks like Abelaji has come from the bottom to the top, like Arsenal, to win. Elijah were sharing their work together on that table. But you know, we do not encourage exam malpractice. A round of applause for Pierre G. There's round two, I believe.
Yes.
Yes.
Now let's get to know you and your journey with poetry.
Hello everyone. It's really nice to be in Port Harcourt. I started writing poetry at an early age, or I started writing scribbles of what I thought was poetry, very bad stuff. But I had teachers and friends who were really kind to tell me that, oh, you're doing the right thing. But it was when I got to university, my first degree was in English, that was when I got to realize that, oh, these guys have been scamming you. Because when I started reading real poetry, I was mind blown. But unfortunately, at that level, I had very beautiful teachers, like Professor Tinubu, Dr. Jima, who were teaching me what they knew of poetry. But the sad thing with Nigerian university system many times is it's almost like rote. They try to recreate you in their mold.
So, I've been asked whether it helps healing. I just say it makes it better for me to carry this wound, you know, a little bit with grace, and also to just perpetuate the light that is my daughter in my heart, in the world, and hope that, you know, like the things I've gone through and the way that I have recorded, documented the story, you know, would serve as a light, you know, for others to also, you know, like engage with their emotions, even if they're men. Do not shy away from crying, do not shy away from screaming, do not shy away from showing the emotion, do not shy away from being vulnerable.
Okay, we also see a little bit of history there. We see a reference to the Aba Women's Riot. We see, you know, something about King Jaja of Okobo. Are you also bringing in that aspect of Nigerian history in your writing in this book? Romeo?
Especially the Aba Women Riot, most times when it's being told, right, it's being told from the perspective of, oh, there is women who were protesting for taxes. And for me, I'm someone who really spends a lot of time in the archive. I'm really looking at documents and really looking at history. As documents are also very, very important to the present day. And so when you look, for example, the history of feminism in Nigeria or the contemporary studies of feminism in Nigeria, especially in our online spaces, you would also see that a lot of what the Aba Women were doing, or what you can do about women riot, because there were women from other spaces that were not even reading about. They went from the Niger Delta, for example, who were part of that movement. So when you start seeing what those people were doing, you can also see how, for example, it's very relevant to our people's society in terms of whether it's protest, whether it's reclaiming spaces that have been taken from people.
Who was the 2022 winner for the Nigeria Prize for Literature? This is a trick question. Is it? Who was the 2022 winner for the Nigeria Prize for Literature? Is it me? I'll give it to who are you people answering? You're an event and you answer those things. I don't know. This is why we feel down. This is why we feel down. Anne! A round of applause for Anne! A round of applause for her. Yes. Yes, Ellen Timo's show. Oh, a round of applause, a round of applause. Bruno, all these gifts brought to you by NLNG. Thank you very much.
Of our dance drama is Bolo Bolo, the beginning. A bitter Mother Earth has been relegated to the background. Her voice silenced. Her power ignored, and yet she carries the problem of the world on her shoulders. Who can relate to her pain? Has that one tasted beauty? The feeder has now been fed, but mother would always be mother. And so we celebrate you, Ibitare, for you are indeed a virtuous woman.
Yeah.
running through the genre of literature, prose fiction, drama, sorry, children's literature, prose fiction, drama, and today poetry. What it means is that for us as an organization, excellence is key. It's not just about the numbers or the effort, but those whose works have been found to be in terms of structure, content, and indeed the quality of production, where the judges look at these works and they say, look, you know what, we have entries that have won. Unfortunately, sometimes we don't have winners, but I'm sure the quiz that we had also showed that for the entries, sometimes we don't get to get winners, not because we want to keep the money back, but because quality and excellence is key. The writers, we eventually identify and awarded $100,000 in the past can compete, their works can compete or be recognized anywhere in the world.
Well, first of all, is to encourage them, because sometimes in the space in which we work, it can be difficult, because many times it's about passion, it's about interest, not really about money, and yet we need to meet our needs, and we need money to meet our needs. So sometimes it's discouraging when little groups want to come together and do things, they're looking for sponsors. But you know what, you don't even need sponsors to do a lot of things, like to get together with your friends and read a book, to encourage the young people around you to read. You don't need money for that. So I would say that let us keep at it. Keep, you know, loving books, keep exploring books through books, and encourage the younger people to do the same as well. Encourage people around us, not just young people, even the older people.
I said it's my house, I see me got a small wall. Me got a small wall. As me I wake up, now she did my mind don't walk.
Oh,